DOMS, 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 DOMS! Good morning, family of fast. Matt Mosman, the Chief Endurance Officer over at EndurElite, here today to talk to you about DOMS, otherwise known as Delayed Onset Muscle Soreness, also known as why the do my muscles hurt so much after doing exercise I'm not used to, or doing strenuous exercise in general, or just pushing yourself, and why does it happen 24 to 48 hours later? So today, what we're gonna talk about real quick is what DOMS is, explain the possible causes of DOMS, tell you the real reason why DOMS occurs, and then tell you how you can prevent DOMS. So, in the simplest sense, delayed onset muscle soreness, like I said before, is that really tender, sore, painful muscle soreness 24 to 48 hours after doing exercise you're unaccustomed to, like chopping wood or, you know, throwing spears or, you know, whatever else you might do, or after doing really strenuous exercise, or coming back to exercise after a layoff and you go out and exercise or do these exercises you're unaccustomed to and you are limping around like a geriatric for a couple days afterwards. Now, over the years, there's been a lot of possible explanations as to why DOMS occurs. The first one was researchers thought that DOMS was caused by lactic acid buildup during exercise. And if you think that is the right answer, you're wrong. And here's why. Lactate/lactic acid after exercise or intense exercise generally returns to baseline about 60 minutes after exercise ceases. So there's really no good explanation as to why lactic acid slash lactate would cause this muscle soreness 24 to 48 hours later. Another explanation back in the day was DOMS was caused by muscle spasms. Now this one is such a dumb explanation that I'm not even gonna go into it. And then the last possible cause is that DOMS is caused by tears in the muscle and the connective tissue and tendons during exercise. Now this third explanation really isn't too far off. So the real reason that DOMS occurs is it's basically tissue damage caused by excessive mechanical force from doing exercise you're not accustomed to or doing strenuous exercise that causes very small micro tears in the muscles in the connective tissue. And this is actually backed up by research via something called electron microscopy that has examined athletes after excessive exercise or exercise they're unaccustomed to. They do this electron microscopy technique and they see all these little micro tears in the muscle. So that is your real cause of delayed onset muscle soreness. Now, we're gonna geek out here for about a minute or two, and I'm gonna take you through the process of what happens during DOMS that leads you to be very sore 24 to 48 hours after doing that exercise you're unaccustomed to or doing strenuous exercise. And I'm gonna throw up a graph here real quick so you can kind of see the explanation as far as how DOMS occurs. So let's get right into it. So, the first thing that happens during DOMS is strenuous muscular contractions, especially eccentric contractions, result in structural damage in the muscle. Two, membrane damage occurs, including damage to the membranes of the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now, the sarcoplasmic reticulum is a vessel that releases calcium and is basically necessary for muscular contractions to occur. So the damage of the sarcoplasmic reticulum causes calcium to leak out of the SR, our sarcoplasmic reticulum, and collects in the mitochondria, which inhibits ATP production. when you inhibit ATP production, that is not a good thing. That is going to be lack of energy right there. The buildup of calcium is also going to activate enzymes which degrade cellular proteins, including contractile proteins, which would be actin and myosin. 5, membrane damage combines with a breakdown of muscle protein and results in an inflammatory process, which includes an increase in histamine production and production of free radicals. And then finally, what happens is the accumulation of all these histamines and free radicals causes swelling around the muscle fiber that stimulates free nerve endings, aka pain receptors, which results in the cessation of pain in the muscle. Or DOMS. So that's kind of a little bit of science of the process of DOMS. Now, what are the researchers recommending to avoid DOMS? With strenuous exercise or the exercise you're not used to, sometimes it's just going to happen. There's not a damn thing you can do about it. But with exercise you're unaccustomed to, like say if you start lifting weights or incorporate a new movement into your exercise routine, the researchers basically suggest that you start practicing these movements slowly over the course of 5 to 10 days to let your body get used to the movement, to the new stress, and this will minimize DOMS to a lesser extent, minimize DOMS than as if you were to just like jump in at full bore and then you'd experience that laundry list of things that happens during DOMS. So that's one thing you can do to kind of combat DOMS. Now, the other thing you may be thinking is, well, if DOMS is an inflammation process, why don't I just don't do, the ice baths or cryotherapy or supplements like green tea or tart cherry that would minimize the inflammation process and then hence minimize DOMS so you can bounce back quicker. Now, every once in a while, I think that using those techniques or supplements to minimize the inflammation process is okay, like if you have a back-to-back day of racing. But in general, you don't really want to minimize the inflammation process because that can impair adaptations to exercise over the long haul. So, that in a nutshell is DOMS. Take home points, DOMS is caused by micro tears in the muscles. It causes swelling, it stimulates pain receptors, and basically you're hobbling around in pain for 24 to 48 hours. To minimize it, incorporate new movements slowly into your routine, maybe do some ice baths and cryotherapy and supplements every once in a while, but over the long haul, I would not do that at all. So, if you have a friend who experiences DOMS on a regular basis, please share this video with them. If you want other videos like this on endurance training, nutrition, and supplementation, subscribe to the EndurElite YouTube channel or head on over to the EndurElite blog at www.endurelite.com or get social with us on the EndurElite Training and Nutrition Club Facebook page or Instagram. And until next time, my endurance friends, stay fueled, stay focused, stay fast, and stay informed.